Hello everyone. Today we are going to see coaxial cable which comes under the guided media. We already know that transmission media consists of the two types, guided media, which is also called as the wired media, and another one is the unguided media, which is called as wireless media, right? So in guided media, there are three types of the cables available. One is twisted pair cable, another second is coaxial cable, and the third one is fiber optic cable. So in the last session, we have already discussed about the twisted pair cable. Today we are going to see coaxial cable. Now, as you can see the diagram, this is the construction diagram for coaxial cable. The elements which are available here is insulator is available, inner conductor is there, and outer conductor is there. Also, the plastic cover is there. So coaxial cable has a central core conductor of solid or standard wire. Usually, it is made up of the copper wire enclosed in an insulating shield, which is in turn encased in an outer conductor of metal foil, braid, or sometimes it is the combination of both. This outer conductor is also encapsulated in an insulating shield, and the whole cable, this entire cable, will be again encapsulated into this plastic cover. Okay. Now, this is the basic structure of the coaxial cable. You just have to remember about the elements which are already available: central core conductor, then outer conductor, which is also called as the braided mesh, then insulator and plastic cover. Basically, this braided mesh just prohibits the outer signals so that outer signals or the noise cannot affect the inside signals. Okay. Now, to connect this coaxial cable with any device, we need a connector. Like in twisted pair cable, we have also discussed about the connector which is used to connect twisted pair cable with the devices is RJ45. Likewise, in twisted pair cable, in coaxial cable, we have three type of the connectors. One is the BNC connector. The second is BNC T connector, and the third one is BNC terminator. Okay. Now here, this BNC connector is used for, basically this BNC is nothing but Bennett Neil Conselman. This BNC connector is used in the TV set while we are connecting the dish antennas and the wire which we use to connect that will be connected with this BNC connector. Then BNC T connector, to connect the computer in the Ethernet network, we use this BNC T connector. Now the BNC terminator, to prevent the reflection of signal used at the end of the cable. Okay. Simply, you just have to remember, to prevent the reflection of the signal, we use this terminal. We use this connector. So these three type of the connectors are used in coaxial cable. Now, coaxial cable consists of the two type of the categories. One is the baseband and another is the broadband. Now, baseband is what? This baseband coaxial cable is used for the digital transmission. A 50 ohm coaxial cable is used. It defines the process of transmitting a signal, or we can say a single signal at the same time with very high speed. This is generally used for local area networks, but the limitation by using this baseband coaxial cable is it needs the amplification after every 1,000 feet. Okay, so baseband coaxial cable is to transmit a single signal at the same time with a very high speed. Now, the second category is the broadband category. This broadband coaxial cable is used to transmit the analog transmission while we are using in cable television cabling. In that, we use this type of the cable. It defines the process of transmitting multiple signals simultaneously with very high speed. It covers large area if we compare with the baseband coaxial cable. Okay, so the basic difference is here. At the same time or simultaneously, we can transport the multiple signals, and in baseband, we transmit a single signal at the same time. Okay. Now, advantages of coaxial cable: high bandwidth, easy to install, less costly, better protection from noise. High bandwidth means it basically, if we are providing the high bandwidth, that means we can transmit the large number of the data. Okay. So if we compare with the fiber optic cable, or if we compare with the another type of another any method of transmission media, then it is very easy to install. Also, another cable like fiber optic cable is very costly. while we are actually implementing that, if we compare that, this cable is much cheaper. Okay, this is less costly. That is why it is used in very large number. Okay. Now, because of its the nature of braided mesh area, braided area, also the plastic cover is there. So number of things are there which is encapsulating the original signal, and because of that, it provides the better protection. And obviously, it will give the protection from the noise. So no crosstalk will be possible in this case, right? Now, the applications where we can use the coaxial cable, basically television distribution, as I already mentioned, in by using the broadband type of the coaxial cable, we use in cable television, right? Also in local area network, we use baseband coaxial cable. Then while we have to use the long distance telephone transmission also, we can go with the coaxial cable. So simply you have to remember where we need a cheap, or we can say less costly wire, but we need a better performance, that time we can go with the coaxial cable. So this is all about the coaxial cable. I hope you understood this point. You just have to remember this diagram and the basic things regarding this configuration. Okay, thank you.